A small smoke-filled arena, just this side of the Twilight Zone.
Let me tell you something, Mr. Smith, it's not worth it. I had a nightmare about a weird little man with a crooked cigar who caused terrible things to happen so he could get scoops for my paper. Well, I'm awake now, and I want you out of here.
Not so fast. What about our contract?
What about our contract?
You said you'd do anything to make your paper a success. I heard you. That's why I came. Well, I've carried out my part. You are a success.
If you're not a nightmare, then you're something even worse. Because somehow you made these things happen. You've caused tragedy. You've destroyed life and property. I didn't bargain for this.
Oh, yes, you did. But you put it out of your mind. You thought you'd get everything for nothing. That's not the way life works. Well, don't worry about it. You're not the first editor I've helped.
I don't want your help. I want you out of my life.
Can't do that now. We have an obligation between us. There is no way out.
Hold it.
There's one way, of course.
And what's that?
You can pay up right now.
I suppose that means that you can't take my immortal soul while I'm alive and walking around. Is that it?
Something like that. Now, wait. This old nose smells a story coming in. Be solid, man.
What about Miss Benson? At 11:30 tonight, Miss Jacqueline Benson, former secretary to Douglas Winter, editor of the Courier, suffered grave injuries resulting from a head-on collision between her car and that of James Edward Slocum returning from a skiing trip. The accident took place on Bascom Road.
That won't stop it. You still think I'm a nightmare, do you?
Change it.
I can't change it. The little modifications I made altered this machine quite a bit. Whatever it writes comes to pass.
But why, Jackie? What did she ever do to you?
She slapped me.
And you destroy her for that?
Of course not. You're an intelligent man. You keep missing the point. You see, I've spent too much time with you already. I have other clients waiting. I want to move on. I figured this story about your girlfriend would hurry things up. Let me point out that the item did not say that she died of her injury. Not yet. I can add a few lines either way. Whether she lives or dies depends on you. Now, if you decide to conclude the contract, you'll find this a lot surer than the bridge. Quicker, too. That leaves you three. Where are you going?
There's got to be some way to stop you, and I'm going to find it.
That's the spirit. Never give up. But remember, you only have 1 hour and 15 minutes.
Reporter and chief linotype operator for the Courier resigned his position and left Dansburg for his home at 11:29 this evening. His contract with Mr. Douglas Winter was declared null and void owing to Mr. Winter's incomplete understanding of the terms of the document.
Contract? What contract?
It means
what?
That he's gone.
Gone?
And he won't be back.
Did he say so?
No, but he never goes anyplace. He's not invited.
What do you mean, invited? Did you invite him here in the first place?
Well, in a way I did. In a way I did. And I'm going to spend the rest of my life making up for it, too. The first thing we do is get rid of this machine. And then we're going to take on the Gazette.
Doug, will you please explain this? I don't know what you're talking about.
I'll tell you. Maybe tomorrow. Right now, let's get out of here.
Exit the infernal machine. And with it, his satanic majesty, Lucifer, Prince of Darkness, otherwise known as Mr. Smith. He's gone, but not for good. That wouldn't be like him. He's gone for bad. And he might be back with another ticket to the Twilight Zone.